Hey Spuds, I'm UPotato22, and we are back with West of Loathing. I almost said Little Inferno for some reason. It's been a long day. So, a couple of things screwed up, and, like, my recording went all haywire, and I had to go and replay a bunch of stuff, and I don't know where I left off last time. But, this is me. We have on a sloppy cowboy hat, a sheriff badge, deputy pistol, varmint skin and knife, and all that stuff. And we're at the Butterfeld Ranch or something like that. I also found a book when I was replaying called Stupid Walking. Look at this stupid. It's got a whole bunch of cute little stupid walks. So, yeah. Anyways, we're gonna fight this cow. Shouldn't be too big of an issue. So we finished all of the, missions for the little chef guy. We had to get him a murder pepper, and then we had to get him his sauté knife, whatever that is. And then we had to get him a, thingamajig. I can't brain. There we go. Okay, we had to get him his sauté knife from his P.O. box, and then we had to get him the secret jerk recipe that his jerk friend Dave J. stole. So we had to go to this Dave yard. Apparently that's where they bury all the Daves. And then tainted beefsteak and extra thick leather. Yeah, cool. And then, yeah. We found a couple places. We gave the dog a bone outside of the cavern. Or not cavern, but wherever this is. The Desert House gang. We gave the dog a bone. With a knick-knack paddywhack. There's a rope tied to the fence post. We're gonna grab that bad boy. And a haystack, which means we get a needle. That's pretty helpful. Something buried in the smoldering embers. I got a red hot poker. Nice. You notice some words carved into the side of the outhouse. Curly was here. Wait a second. You recognize that name? Curly. Curly Butterfield. The legend of Curly's meat? Looks like maybe this outhouse is worth investigating. Let's investigate it. Luckily, you don't actually go inside the outhouse, because once you open the door, you find a map scratched into the inside of it. The map reveals the location of a mine just west of the ranch, labeled Coal Ridge. Huh. There's an inset map of the mine itself, with a big X scrawled between three strange triangular icons. Curious. Very curious. You have one bottle of cow's milk. Let's make some butter. Infernal butter. You have nothing to churn. Okay. I need lockpicking two for that. I haven't checked how much. Oh, I have 269 unspent XP. I need 400. That sucks. Okay. Alrighty then. What are these? To your horror, you see that every single cow in the Butterfield dairy herd is now an Ungolith, an infernal cow spirit bound in stone. They're not dangerous, unless you get near them. Let's walk among them. We're gonna beat up a rock shaped like a cow. Alrighty then. You thinned the herd a little. Not enough. It can never be enough. I got a menudo geode and a cow's eye. Susie carves another notch in the stock of her rifle. Cow hate flashes in her eyes. Her resolve intensifies. Susie has become stronger. Way to go. Let's walk among them again. Holy crap! She became a lot stronger. God damn. I have 299. We could keep doing this, but it'll be a while. Oh no, I have two of them. That might be bad. wicked strong, though. Sweet. But only towards cows. Okay. How much did I gain from that? Gain 30. It would be a while. But you know what? We're gonna keep a trucking on. Nice. Good job, Susie. I'm really glad I brought her along, because she is extremely helpful, I've discovered. Almost dead. That's okay. He dead. Brass bullring, infernal soul fragment, and cow's eye. Nice. Okay, we're gonna keep going. We've almost got 400. Oh jeez, there's three of them though. I might die this time. We'll see though. 40 and 36. So we're gonna for sure knock you out. There we go. And then I'm about to die. Oh no, Susie. Seriously? You get so angry about losing that fight that you pass out. You wake up the next morning in your bed. Susie must have carried you back here after you got knocked out. You're a little sore, but otherwise, not otherwise any worse for wear. You're pretty hungry though, and sober. Dang it. Okay. Back to the Butterfield Ranch. Butterfield Ranch. Destroyed campsite. Ooh. Okay, so we'll have to go check that. We're finding a lot of stuff. Do I have enough XP? Probably not. Nope, 359. Keep fighting the cows! The cow monoliths. Fight me! There's three of them again. I'm gonna lose again. Oh, and they do 15 damage. Can I leave? Oh, well, I didn't have to. Okay. Fine. We'll go do something else. How about we go to the Coleridge Mine? You hear a rattling noise behind you. Another rattling noise off to your left, and a third rattling noise somewhere up ahead. You conclude that you've either stumbled into the nest of babies or a nest of rattlers. A quick glance confirms that it's a ladder. Not unexpected, really. This is no place for babies. We'll fight them. Even though apparently that hasn't been working out too well. Oh, jeez. Okay. Please do 14 damage. Yes! Sweet. Oh! Well, apparently she does a lot of damage on all of them. Okay. Nice! Whew. 15 XP, snake liver, rattlesnake skin. Nice job. Yeah! Okay, so what have we got here? Let's go back into this mine. Or into this mine. There's a row of lockers here. Must have been used for storing the personal effects of the fellers who used to work in this mine. The first one is labeled Ellsbury WM and doesn't have a lock on it. The label on the second one is covered in some kind of white goo. The third one is labeled Loose Ben and has a combination lock on it. Let's open the first one. Got a helmet and a bottle of laudanum. Okay. Let's open the second locker. Yo, open the door to reveal a skeleton covered in the same white goo. Ah, you get it. The guy must have died after his coworkers played a prank on him where they stuffed him into this locker and then filled it with shaving cream. I can't believe you dang jerk stuffed me into my locker and then filled it with shaving cream. I died from that, yells the skeleton, confirming both your insight and his vengeful, murderous intent. Oh my gosh, that's so weird. Target, a shaving cream covered skeleton. 92 HP. Holy crap. So maybe instead of like waiting to level up my my lock picking skills, I should start leveling up like my damage and everything. It's a good thing they don't do much damage. They can take a lot of damage, but they don't do much damage. Skull chip, skeleton bone, handful of loose teeth. Okay. I'm gonna start doing these stuff. I have 300, yeah. Mysticality, Moxie, Grit. What's Grit do? Okay. So I'll upgrade Gumption as well, and then Glamour. That's Tough Customer. Yeah. And Intimidating. And then we'll do Muscle Up again. And Mysticality. Cool. Okay. Open the third locker. There's a combination lock and you don't know the combination. Let's loot it. 59 meat. Exposed meat vein. Whoa, this just opens into onto a 30-foot shaft. Tie a rope to the crossbeam. Climb down. Nice. Let's dig. There's a compass buried here. Okay. I'm riding my lantern. Nice. Loot it. Oh. You don't like this. This cart looks like it's only partially real. Loot it anyways. Black fluid oozes from the vein. A scabrous mass sits below on the floor. Okay. Reach inside. It goes further than you expected. It's warm. Urine up to the shoulder when you feel it. A beating heart. Rip it out. Oh, this is weird. Oof, looks like this guy should have picked better friends. Let's take the pickaxe. The spiral makes you feel queasy. Oh wait, there's a cart there. Reach in. Okay. Well, this is weird. Mine it. Mine it. Up again. I'm getting a lot of meat. I don't even really need it yet, but I have it. Okay. Let's go back to the map. See what we got. We have a destroyed campsite. Let's go check that out. Dynamite Dan's Discount Dynamite Dare House. Okay. We'll go check that out soon. What's this? Search the knapsack. I got potted meat. Most of the contents are trashed from being stomped on. You do find a dented can of potted meat, though. You also notice that the knapsack has a knife sheath strapped to the side, but you don't see any knife anywhere. This tent is a real mess. It looks like it was trampled by a whole herd of cows. There's something odd about it, though. This campfire has been thoroughly stomped on and kicked. Someone was real serious about fire safety. Yikes, you think maybe this used to be a person? What a mess. Cows did this to a guy? I reckon so, judging from those tracks, but what's wrong? Something about these tracks ain't quite right. What do you mean? They aren't spaced out right, and they're uneven. Okay, what does that mean? I'd say either the cow that made these tracks was drunk, or it wasn't a cow that made them. There are cow tracks leading away from the mangled corpse. It probably wouldn't be hard to follow them. Follow them. Since you have reason to believe these tracks may be a fake, you could either follow them or head in the opposite direction. Let's follow the tracks. You follow the cow tracks for 100 yards or so, after which they stop suddenly. There doesn't seem to be anything of interest nearby. Well done. Can I go back to the campsite? Follow the tracks, but go the opposite way. You head in the opposite direction for about half a mile and discover another campsite, this one occupied. You observe the campers carefully from a distance before approaching. They're dressed weirdly in brightly colored baggy clothes with white face paint. As you get closer, you realize they're dressed up as rodeo clowns. Gross. Why would they do that? There doesn't seem to be a rodeo happening anywhere near here. Let's approach the camp. This rodeo clown is playing a harmonica. The tune he's playing basically goes, doot doot doodle-loodle oot doot doot doo. Say hello. He nods politely but keeps playing. Okay. How about you? He is eating a comically large haunch of meat. He narrows his eyes at you to say, mine. This clown is idly juggling a knife. Howdy, stranger, he says with a smile. Converse. Howdy. What are you guys doing out here? The clowns exchange glances. Camping? You can tell by the campfire. What I mean is, there's no rodeo or circus around here, so why are you guys in rodeo clown outfits? Oh, that. Our circus is up north. We're on break, so we decided to take in the sights. What sights? This is the middle of nowhere. Nonsense. Check out those cactuses over there. And those mountains. And, well, all the sand. Plenty of things to see. What circus? I didn't hear anything about a circus in the area. Oh, you wouldn't have. It's just a little traveling show. You aren't really missing anything. What's it called, though? The clown hesitates and shrugs. It's called Barnaby Bob's Perfectly Normal Traveling Circus Sideshow. Perfectly normal? Why is it called that? He narrows his eyes at you. Accuracy. How far north is it? Oh, pretty far. Too far for you to worry about. No, really, how far? Sigh, it's up near Goblin Gulch. Wow, that is really far north. Right, exactly. Too far. You walked all the way from there? Wait a minute. You guys walked all the way down here from the northernmost part of territory for sightseeing on your break? We get really long breaks. We have a good union. Where is this circus exactly? Why would you even want to go there? Look, don't worry about it. Just tell me already. I want to enjoy some whimsical frickin' merriment, okay? Just tell me where your damn circus is already. The clown's eyes flash angrily, but he quickly smooths his expression with an appeasing smile. All right, partner, all right. Just trying to save you a long journey and all. Here, I'll mark it on your map. Thanks. Couldn't ask for a discount. That's sad. Okay. So, we're gonna go to Dynamite Dan's real quick. And then we'll check out the other things. Before you can react to a sudden howling, a ghost train surges over the hill and roars past, just missing you. Three skeleton train robbers arrive just behind it and barely avoid colliding with you by pulling back hard on their reins. The train vanishes in the distance and the robbers seem really annoyed by your interference. Oh, we'll attack the ghost or the skeletons. Nice. And then you. Let me just put that back in thin air. Hey. Nice. Okay. Dynamite Dan. Okay then. A year's supply of dynamite and dynamite. Alright, well I don't think I need either of those. But real quick though, I forgot I have some cool stuff. So. Rattlesnake skin. Put it on your hat to add up 3 muscle. Apply to hat. You wrap the skin around your hat and clip it together with the snake's fangs, which you forgot to remove from the skin. Okay. Curly's compass. This was Curly Butterfield's compass, but that dude must have always been lost because the thing points every which way but north. Examine it. The compass needle is pointing generally northwestish. Okay. That's weird. It's not clear whether this gem looks like the malevolent burning eye of a demon cow, or if it looks around like one. Ooh. Creepy. Oh, I have advanced cow punching. Let's read that. Haymaker, combat skill that deals damage and briefly stuns. Gore, a skill that lets you attack an entire row of enemies. Thick skin, a skill that increases your armor, protecting you against melee. There's a chapter written by a guy who survived 17 different near-fatal gorings. He really learned a lot about getting gored. Let's learn gore. Unfortunately, you accidentally gore the book into bits while practicing what you've learned. Crap. Okay, so I don't really need anything from Dynamite Dan. I'm gonna go back to the mercantile. Actually, let's go to Snake Pit Mine. See what's over there. And also, there was something I wanted to do in one of the places. Hold on. You look at the mining equipment. You have no idea what any of it does. Ask Susie to explain it to you, or explain it to Susie. Ooh, let's explain it to Susie. Hey, Susie. What? I just wanted to tell you about this mining stuff. Okay. So this first machine here, this is an automatic gold conveyor. Susie stares at you blankly. Move on to the next machine. And this thing over here, this thing is used to extract hard rock and then flatten it. Susie sighs. Keep going. And this third machine is an acidic rubble roller. It converts ore into black peat. You got a perk. Mindsplainer. Susie rolls her eyes. Are you finished? Yeah, sorry, Susie. Mindsplainer. What does that perk do? Oh, wait. Wrong one. Oop. You're a real expert. You'll gain XP when you interact with mining stuff. Is that like mansplainer? I like that. Can I see how much? I have 24 XP unspent. Nice. Okay, so mine this. Plus you get 10 XP in. Oh, nice. Sweet. Okay, so into here. Well, that looks like a pair of eyeballs. You can see a snake coiled up in the little hole. Pull it out and punch it. 18. And 37. I wish she could go first sometimes. Hooray. Dig through it. And I get XP for that now. That's sweet. Nice. Okay, mining supplies. Dynamite and sulfur match. The den is full of snake eggs. Let's pull them out. Okay. Oh, and then they hatch. Alrighty. Gore. Hit every enemy in this row for 9 damage. Oh, I should have done it that way. Okay. Never mind. That was dumb. Oh well. That's a cool thing, though. They look like little staffs or something. I don't know. They look weird when they're dead. Okay. 30 XP, 56 meat. There's not enough skin on any of them to be worth collecting. Okay, that's fine. Oh, look, a pickaxe. We're gonna pick it up. That's pretty great. A meat vein. Ugh. Hey. I still got that mindsplaining bonus. That's awesome. I love that. Okay, so we got all that stuff. I want to go to Stern's Ranch again. There was a couple things there that I couldn't get to. Out in the middle of the desert, you find an abandoned minecart. Okay. It's mostly full of plain old rocks. Not even very interesting looking ones. Oh, but I still get the mindsplaining bonus. However, if you left without searching it thoroughly, you'd just end up driving yourself crazy later with the thought that you might have missed something valuable. And so you spend a good half an hour inspecting rocks and eventually find one that might be worth something. Nice. Okay. So we're gonna go in here. Because there was a toy chest. It says the toy box contains a single object, a creepy burnt porcelain doll. We're gonna talk to it. It's the work of a moment to fix the doll's voice box. Pull the string. You pull the string. The doll's eyes roll back into its head, and its mouth begins to move. Oh, that's creepy.
Hi, I'm Grace. What's your name?
I'm Spudsy.
Hi, Spudsy. You're nice. Do you want to play with me?
Yeah, let's play.
Hooray! Mary used to play with me, but we didn't get to finish our tea party before she went away. Will you help me finish it?
Surely. I don't know how long I can keep that voice up.
Hooray! The game is almost over. Mary did such a good job.
The doll's eyes roll back forward.
Go downstairs and get my cup. Do you know the magic word to make the mean cow let you into his secret room?
No, what is it?
The magic word is peanut butter.
The doll goes silent. Got it. Peanut butter. You shudder as you realize that talking dolls haven't been invented yet. Spooky. Yeah, that is pretty spooky. Can I look through this? Nothing else of interest here unless you're interested in burn books. You're not. How do you know, though? I have dug through two spittoons. Okay, so there's a weird cow-shaped stain on the wall. Whisper peanut butter. Oh geez, altar room? Atop this sinister-looking altar sits a copper goblet filled with what appears to be blood. Let's take the goblet. Ugh. Okay. Now let's go give this back to the creepy doll. Talk to it.
My tea! We can finish our tea party now.
Sure, why not?
You carefully pour the blood from the goblet onto Grace's mouth, or into Grace's mouth.
Ah!
Grace leaps out of the toy box, laughing maniacally, and climbs the ranch house's ruined chimney. She turns towards you.
See you soon.
She leaps to the ground behind the house and scampers off to the northwest.
That's probably fine. I'm sure nothing bad will come of that.
Okay. There was something else I was gonna do. We got the railroad camp. We got those. We got the circus. I think I might go back to Dirtwater for a little bit. Sell some stuff. Ooh! Silversmith's house. Let's go there. Silversmith's house. I have some silver. The sign says, silver bullet making apparatus. Help yourself. Ooh, let's help ourselves. The workbench has a little burner and crucible for melting silver things and some bullet molds. It seems pretty straightforward. There's also a vise you can smash silver bullets into needles if you wanted to. Okay, let's make one bullet with the silver nugget and three bullets with the silver cufflinks and make needles. How many silver bullets do I have? Oh, that many. Okay, cool. I have a crap ton of needles now. Pick the lock. Got it. Go inside. There's a note on the safe reading, I forgot the darn combination of this confounded thing. If you can open it, you're welcome to what's in it. Crack the safe. Requires safe crack in 3. Oh, sad sauce. The shelf looks pretty picked over. Let's search it. Instant grits and plum pudding. Excellent. This bookshelf contains like 90 copies of Johnny Tremaine. There's something weird about it, though. It's too neatly organized. Like maybe the guy was hiding something. Search for secrets requires 10 moxie. Okay, so we need more moxie. I have 7. 8, 9. Shoot, I'm so close. Do I have something that can give me moxie? Oh, that's not what I meant to click. Do you give me moxie? Yeah! One more moxie. You gain an effect, Plum Exuberant. No dark sarcasm here. Okay. I should have read the other part because now I'm confused. Search for secrets! Tucked behind one of the books, you find a small envelope filled with receipts. About half of them are from a shop called the Silver Plater. He was crooked! The silversmith was selling cheap fakes! Ah well, he's gone now, and so are most of his customers. No sense in stirring up trouble at this point. You write down the location of the shop. Might come in handy. Let's hit the road. Oh, a spittoon! A spittoon! At least, it looks like a spittoon, but it's next to the bed. It might actually be a bedpan. Investigate it! Wait, really? I mean, if it is just a spittoon, that's bad enough. but it might be a bedpan, and that would be way worse. A bedpan is what people go to the bathroom in. I feel like maybe you aren't getting what I'm saying. We're talking about an object that someone probably uses when they wake up in the middle of the night and can't be bothered to walk to the outhouse. And the best you can hope for is maybe they only use it to spit nighttime tobacco juice into it. In which case it's only full of rancid, congealing tobacco spit. Investigate it. I'm investigating it. Are you even listening to me? Or are you just sort of skimming past the text? Bedpan. Look, I'm pretty sure there's treasure in there and you aren't stopping me. Bedpan. Shut up. I'm investigating. Okay, fine. Have it your own way. Your own filthy, disgusting way. It turns out probably not to be a bedpan, but it is definitely a spittoon, and it is definitely filled with rotting brown spit. Fish around in it. What is wrong with you? Bite me! Oh, good God. Okay, you plunge your hand in up to the wrist, it makes a gloop noise, and breaks the thin skin of congealing toxins that was previously keeping the dire smell in relative check. Now you're choking on a miasma of oily, bitter chaw stink. You know that feeling you get when you're about to puke? How you get that taste way back in the rear corners of your mouth? That metallic tang by the root of your tongue? Like you're sucking on a corroded old penny? Just tell me what I found already. You found a filthy, slime-covered old brooch. Are you happy? I bet you're going to put it on without even washing it first. Maybe I will! So there! Did I put it on? No, I didn't put it on. What's this do? Ooh, lots of fun stuff. Ha ha ha. This brooch would be much smaller if it weren't for the thick layer of tarnish and dried tobacco spit. Gross. Okay. Now let's go back to Dirtwater. You find a pair of saddlebags slung over a tree branch. Stencil letters on the side read, "Property of Fort All Dead Library." Dig through the bags. The bag is full of books, mostly boring military field manuals. You do find one of specific interest to you, though. Cow punching. Nice. Continue on. Okay. And then we'll read the cow punching. Read it. Ever Vigilant, a perk that increases your maximum AP by 2. Haymaker, or the old 1-2-3, a skill that lets you perform 3 punch attacks in quick succession. Ooh. Let's do that one. Unfortunately, you're not very good at stopping punching, and you punch the book to bits. Aw. Ah, well. Okay. What's wrong, sir? This guy looks like he's in a lot of pain. Let's check on him. You okay, buddy? I'm pretty sure my leg is broken, so no. Aw. What happened? Traffic incident? No, it just sort of broke all of a sudden. I guess I don't get enough vitamins or whatever. Good nutrition can be difficult in this day and age. I'm gonna need some medicine for this. Can you help me? Sure. Thank you. There's a mission up north. The nuns there run a little hospital and sell medical supplies. Can you get me some broken leg pills? Okay, coming up. One sec, sir. I have an army field trauma kit, though. How come that won't work? Oh, sell that. Sell that. What are the cow's eye for? I don't think they're for anything. I'll sell them, though. Because if I do need them, I know where to get them. we'll sell those. Infernal butter. Nah, I don't need that either. Instant grits, muscle by 3, I don't need that. Moxie by 3, we'll keep that. Menudo geode, moxie by 6 for the rest of the day. We'll keep one of those. We can sell one of the pickaxes. Potted meat. Ooh, muscle mysticality moxie by 5 for the rest of the day. That's pretty good. Red hot poker? 69 damage? Why, I reckon I hardly know her. That's stupid. Okay. So we're gonna sell those. Skull chips, we can sell one of those. Sulfur match. We'll sell that. Tainted beefsteak. Sell that too. Okay. Yeah. Got rid of a lot of crap. Does this guy by any chance have any grease or anything? Nothing. Shoot. Okay. Well, we will go get this sir his broken leg pills, and then we'll call it good. Cavern Canyon, is that where I was going? Oh no, rescue mission. Oh, it's gonna be a while. We're gonna surrender. The stink above pummels you into the bog and then piles some nasty bog mud on top of you just to be rude. Jimmy wraps his tail around your foot and drags you the rest of the way where you were headed. Okay. Gross, though. What do you want? It's your partner. Talk to your partner. Susie looks over her notes. I think there's another ranch in this area. Don't know nothing about it. It's pretty new. Okay, we'll take a look. Am I forgetting anything? Thanks for the reminder. Okay. Gosh, a real-life nun. Yes, I'm Sister Tabitha. I'm Spudsy Wayne. What's with the cots? Well, what with the cow attacks and so on, I felt my faith would be better served by running this place as a clinic rather than just a church. I also sell medical supplies if you'd like your healing to go. Can I buy some medical supplies? I need broken leg pills. That's a lot for a guy that I don't know. Blood-building tonic? That's pretty sweet. Okay. I don't really need that, though. You need me to run any errands? Funny you should ask. I've been experimenting with the healing properties of a purple grass that grows near here, but I've run out. Would you mind picking some for me? It grows near a cave that makes an unusual humming sound. Humming cave. No problem. Okay. We're gonna go give that guy his broken leg pills and then call it good. Because I'm just getting, you know, task after task after task, and I'm tired. You find a crate lying on the side of the trail, its lid knocked loose. It has fell off the back of a cart LTD stenciled in the side, which seems a bit on the nose, but hey, free stuff is free stuff. Fish through the crate and help yourself to the meager but free contents. Ranch punch and depressed rancher candy. Okay. Let's go help this guy with the broken leg. Check on him. Oh, hello. Were you able to get some broken leg pills? Without them, I'm stuck just sort of lying here in the street. Yep, here you go, sir. Whew, thanks. I feel like a new man again. Or at least the same man with a new leg. That's good. Go drink some milk or something, okay? He waves and skips happily away. Well, that was nice. Okay, end on a good deed for today. After we let loose a psycho-talking doll with goblet of blood. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching and like this video to appease the potato overlords. And maybe subscribe so you can become a spud yourself. And I will see you guys again soon. Ciao!